You're welcome for Ericsson Lectures, and I hope that you are ready to enjoy with me the beautiful lesson that I have prepared for you. And our question is an extract from Kastner past paper on financial management. And the question is all about determination of the price per share. Now, this is what the question states, and we are going to use two models. That is the Gordon's model and the Walters model. Now the question states, the following information was extracted from the financial statement of Mwaka Limited. So we have earnings per share is 15 shillings. Capitalization rate is 12%. Retention ratio is 40%. I'm going to explain everything, don't worry. Then internal rate of return is 16%. Now, we now have all the details, but by virtue of paying a price per share, it means that a particular individual will become a member of a company by buying shares. And when they buy shares, they become what is known as shareholder. So you simply become a shareholder when you buy shares from a company. And being a shareholder means that you are entitled to what is known as dividends. In other words, dividends are going to be paid out of the profit which are made by the company. So we are supposed to know that these dividends, they normally grow at some rate, and the price per dividends will all be determined at some specific scenarios. Now, using the Gordon's model, this is a model that recognizes the growth of shares as well as the growth of dividends. That dividends will always grow at some specific rate. So when you talk about this model, when you want to determine the price per share denoted by P not zero, it's supposed to be D not zero into 1 plus G divided by KE minus G. And in this case, D not zero is the dividend paid per share. G refers to growth. G is the growth of the dividend or the growth of the share, which is normally given by BR. So when we talk about B, in terms of growth, B, we are referring to the growth, the retention. The retention ratio. And we are going to explain all of that. Now, retention ratio, when it comes to payment of dividends and shares, means that out of the profit made by the company, not all, everything is going to be paid. Some part is going to be retained back. Like in this case, the retention ratio is 40%. It means what was paid is 100% minus 40, which is 60%. And in this case, R is supposed to be the return on equity. The return on equity. Remember, when the equity means the owner's equity or the owner's claim, that is the ROE, return on equity, that is R. But now, KE is supposed to be the cost of equity. So cost of equity, like in this case, we have capitalization rate of 12%, which is the cost of equity, which is supposed to be vested on it. So having this one, you realize that we have the cost of equity. We are supposed to get dividend per share. And how do we get dividend per share? Essentially, when you talk about dividend per share, we are referring to what is supposed to be paid after retaining the amount times the earnings per share. So our dividend per share is supposed to be the payout ratio, the ratio that was paid times earnings per share. What you earn per share times the ratio that was paid is supposed to be the dividend per share, what you are paid. Like in this case, we are talking about, for us to get the payout ratio, we are supposed to subtract 40% from 100, and we get 60%. Okay, this is what was paid after retaining the other amount. So it means our dividend per share will be 0.6, which is the decimal place, times earnings per share. We are given as 15. So times 15, which is supposed to be 0.6 times 15, supposed to be 9. So we have our dividend per share, which is 9 shillings. Now we have every detail, so it means that for us to have the price per share, it's supposed to be the dividend per share, which is 9 into 1 plus growth. And of course it means we haven't gotten the growth, which is supposed to be the retention ratio, and the ratio that was retained, we are told it is 40%. So plus 0.4 times R, which is the return on equity. And return on equity is supposed to be 12%. That is what is supposed to, that is what is expected from the equity, which is 0.12. Divide everything by K, which is the cost of equity, which is 0.12 minus growth, what we are going to receive here, minus 0.4 times 0.12. So it's supposed to be 9 into, when you multiply 0.4 times 0.12, we get 0.048 plus this one. So it is 9 into 1.0.48 into 0.12 minus 0.048. So we can work out the denominator, which is 0.12 minus the answer is supposed to be 0.072. Now when you work out 9 times 1.048, supposed to be 9.432. When you divide by the 0.072, you get 31. So the answer is supposed to be 131. This is our price per share according to the Walters model. So that's how we do it. Now we now go to, this is according to Godot's model, sorry. Then we go to Walters model, which does not recognize growth. And in this case, for us to gain the price per share, we normally use the formula of dividend per share, which is D0, which is supposed to be added to R divided by KE. And this one is supposed to be factored into the earnings per share minus D0. You divide everything by KE. And of course, K refers to the cost of equity, as we said. Now, we have our dividend per share, R. Now, R here refers to the return on equity. Now, whenever we have return on equity, you divide by the cost of equity. You are essentially talking about what is known as the internal rate of return. Because the return is spread from equity, we divide the return on equity and the cost of equity. So when you do that one, because already we have internal rate of return, it means that our R over KE is summarized to be the internal rate of return, which is given at 0.16. So we only subject this one to our formula and work out. So subjecting whatever we have into the formula, we are going to have the price per share is supposed to be given by the dividend per share, which was realized as 9, supposed to be 9 plus 0.16 into earnings per share, which is 15, minus dividend per share, which is actually 9 again. We divide this one by the cost of equity, which is 0.12. When you work out this one, will be equal to 9 plus 0.16 into the dividends here is 6 divided by 0.12, which will be equal to 9 plus 0.16 times 6, it's supposed to be 0.96. 0.96 plus this is supposed to be 9.96 divided by 0.12. And the answer is supposed to be 9.96. So 9.96 divided by 0.12, we get an answer of